with my homie. I said I found something, he said show me. I think I see a protein, just check the scope. Do you see it? Nope. But it's right there, just by the membrane.
How do you know that's it and not some other peptide chain? Get with the program, don't check your news feed. I think you need some help, and I know what you need.
There's this awesome thing, goes by GFP. It will help you out, just trust me. GFP? But what does that mean?
It stands for green fluorescent protein.
Use it to check if your genes expressed. And for this purpose, it simply is the best. When you're tracking something, attach it to your gene. And under UV light, it will glow bright green.
Osamu Shimomura is the beginning of the story, yeah.
Studied bioluminescence of Icoria Victoria. He found that in order to bioluminesce, Icoria releases calcium ions. They bind to a protein they call the corm, which upon calcium binding turns a blue light on.
This emitted blue light is then absorbed by GFP, which gives off light as green as a tree. In our grand story, this is how it began. Shimomura studying jellyfish, yeah, he's the man.
We've gone through the history, how it came to be, but now let's talk about its structure and its chemistry.
What makes GFP so great? Why has it got so many fans? Got that beta barrel structure with 11 beta strands.
Yeah, check them out, anti-parallel. You can fuse it to a protein's NRC terminal.
So if you need to see where in the cell it's located, translational fusion's got your back, so don't be getting frustrated.
Or you can put the gene for GFP right after the promoter. You can be a real cool gene expression decoder.
Alpha helixes and loops, they help protect the protein's core. Too many oxidizing species and you'll quench the fluorophore. Wanna use another marker? Well, there's something you should know. Yeah, GFP don't need no extra cofactors to glow, but it can do more. Check if your cell is vegetative. You can also make some pretty pictures and get real creative.
That's pretty cool, but stop messing around about those vegetative cells. Your logic is sound. In bacteria, you want to know what makes heterocysts. Put some GFP on PADS and see what you missed.
If you need to observe proteins localized, translational fusion will help visualize.
But if seeing expression is something you need, transcriptional fusion will help you proceed.
This method was invented by Marty Chalfie, and inside of E. coli, he made GFP.
It was the discovery of a great scope and size,
and for it, he won the Nobel Prize. There's this awesome thing, goes by GFP. It will help you out, just trust me.
GFP, but what does that mean?
It stands for green fluorescent protein. Use it to check if your genes expressed. And for this purpose, it simply is the best. When you're tracking something, attach it to your gene. And under UV light, it will glow bright green.